Hello. I am demonstrating for you the HVAC Psychrometric iPad app from ASHRAE. What you're looking at is what's called an iPad emulator, and it looks exactly like your iPad screen, except I am able to demonstrate and do testing of iPad apps on my MacBook. So for the next couple of minutes, I will be demonstrating how to use this psychrometric iPad app. So what you see here is a standard psychrometric chart. And up top here are all of the psychrometric properties based upon where you are in the chart. And then if I scroll a little bit, which on your iPad, you will not have to scroll since your iPad screen is big enough. But on the bottom are various buttons and selections, which I will discuss in a bit. But first, let's just talk about the basics. So here is your psychrometric chart. And as I move my finger, or in this case, my mouse, but on your iPad, obviously, it'll be your finger. As you move it around, you'll see that there are crosshairs, which show you exactly where you're at. And at the top, you'll see that all the properties of where I am located update dynamically. And then, suppose I want to plot a point. Well, down here, you'll see a selector that says point, line, or label. Currently, I'm in the point mode. That means I'm able to plot points. So using your iPad, all you need to do is tap twice anywhere on the chart, and it will plot a point. So there's my point. Now, what if I want to see the exact properties of that point? Well, then I tap that point, and you'll see pops up a point properties form. And these are all the properties of that point. Now suppose that I want my point maybe not to be exactly 107.2 degrees, but more like 109 degrees. Well, all I need to do is put my cursor inside here. Up will pop my on-screen keyboard, and I can change that to 109, click return. And as you can see, the point updates. I can also use my slider control. And as I move the slider, the point will increase or decrease. But let's talk about this form later on. So now I've plotted one point. Now suppose I want to connect a point to another point, create a process. Well, then I need to enter the line mode. I do that by clicking line, and then I use my finger, click the point, and as you can see, a line is being drawn, and I can draw my line to another point. Now, it won't let me do that in that instance, because I already have a line going to that point. So let's try the other point. And there we go. Now, if you click that point again to display the properties form, first you need to go back into the point mode, and now you'll see that point name 3, still the same properties, but now if we go to the other point, we'll see that it's connected from point 3, and it shows me an airflow which I had entered previously. Then if I want to label this point, I click the label button, double click, and type in the label that I want to display here. So that's the basics of creating a point, drawing a line, and typing in a label. There are also lots of other features, which we will cover in future webinars. For example, you can actually create multiple projects. This is just one project. We called it constant sensible heat, but here we have a bunch of projects, and you can create new ones just by clicking the plus button to create a new project. You can also copy existing projects or delete projects just by swiping like this and clicking the delete button. But you'll see as I select my different projects that the chart updates. Let's go back to the project that we initially started with. Now I can customize this chart in any way possible, including changing the colors of lines, hiding or displaying lines, even changing the min and max limits of my chart, changing the elevation so the chart is suitable for elevations other than 0 feet above sea level, in a wide variety of ways. The way I do this is by clicking the little gear icon, and up pops my chart properties form. So here's a whole wide range of options. I'm not going to go through all these now, but I will in a future webinar. But as you can see, you can display English metric, minimum, you can go all the way down to minus 60 degrees Fahrenheit, and you can change specific units that are displayed and colors. So for example, suppose I wanted to display my wet bulb, not in gray, but in green. I just change green, and I want to display my volume line in yellow. I click Save and Redraw, and as you can see, my chart has been redrawn. Now what if I want to delete a point? Well, I select the point while in the point mode and click the little trash icon, and it deletes the point and the line that was connected to it. Suppose I want to see which way the line was drawn. So it displays a little arrowhead to show that I can only draw one line to a point. I can't draw multiple lines to the same point. So this shows me a little visual indicator of that. I can also email all the information about the points and processes on my chart, including a PDF of the chart itself. So if I click my little envelope icon, up pops my email client, and including inside this email client is a list of all the points and all the properties of all the points, and also a PDF of the chart itself that you can email to yourself or anyone else. You can use this chart both in landscape and portrait mode also, depending on what your preference is. If you want to erase the whole chart and start anew, just click this little icon here and it asks you, are you sure you want to clear the chart? Let's not do that right now. So this is a brief overview of how to use the ASHRAE HVAC Psychrometric Chart. Like I said, we will be having future webinars that cover how to use this chart in much more detail. And you can check www.carmelsoft.com for the dates and times of those future webinars.